For this presentation, our objective was to demonstrate the principles of management learned in class by applying them to a TV show of our own creation. We were given the freedom to take the show in any direction that we wanted to, so long as the concepts were captured. The concepts that were emphasized in our show are managerial job dimensions, managing strategically, decision-making process and the rationality model, cross-functional team, human resource management, structured debate, groupthink, SWOT analysis, developing action plans, and obtaining a competitive advantage. These highlighted concepts were specifically tailored around our target audience, which is business majors looking to advance their knowledge in management. Those in this select audience will find the characters to be relatable and will hence be engaged in the absorption of the concepts as they are being exercised through the duration of the show. The show begins by identifying a challenge that the featured manager is facing, and then the viewer joins in on his journey of identifying the problem and his attempt to remedy it by leveraging management skills learned and capturing opportunities. Through the duration of the show, we are taken through all steps of the decision-making process while effectively working in a team environment. NACCTS Engineering is a top-tier company in the electrical engineering field. They specialize in creating innovative telecommunications chips, which they then assemble on-site and sell to vendors. A manager at NACCTS needs to have a solid team in his midst in all avenues of production, from the conception of the product to the sales. And while they have great products, they realize that their human capital is their most valuable asset. They are responsible for hiring great talent, as well as seeing through that all associates receive proper training. They must allocate resources effectively, stay updated on technology, and implement strategy to hold their competitive advantage over the industry. NACCTS is particularly known for their quality products and stellar service. Recently, the CEO of NACCTS Engineering has begun honing in on a substantial loss of profit over the last quarter and gave the manager an ultimatum to improve profit or risk unemployment. It's up to our hero, Derek, to identify problems that could be causing the lower profit and discover opportunities that could increase the profit. And now for the main characters in this show. In the center, you see Derek White. Derek White recently graduated from USF with a bachelor's in entrepreneurship. 6 months following his graduation, he was promoted to head manager at NACCTS. As a head manager, he oversees all production departments, including creation, assembly, quality testing, and sales. He's a strong motivator and great at planning and balancing resources. However, he struggles with being influenced by intimidation tactics. On the far left, you see Tina Gladley. She recently graduated at top of her class, majoring in electrical engineering and minoring in entrepreneurship. She received stellar recommendations from her previous internships and was consequently hired into NACCTS as a lead creative designer. She leverages her specialized job skills to secure her superior value and acts as a liaison between Derek and her fellow co-workers. However, she does not take criticism on her work very well. On the far right, you see Lexi Monti. She's NACCTS sales associate. She was hired in because of her bubbly personality, confidence, and always-be-closing mentality. She is often the face of the company and stands in the figurehead role as she attends many of the formal meetings on behalf of the company. She's responsible for forging quality relationships with clients, new and returning. Lexi's confidence can sometimes get the best of her, though, and she can sometimes be stubborn in asking for help. Next to Lexi is Mario Gatti. He works on the assembly line at NACCTS and has aspirations of being a creative designer. For this, he's somewhat resentful against Tina for being hired in with his dream job. He's always gossiping and enjoys taking shortcuts. His gossip sometimes leads to groupthink situations, and his shortcuts often cost the company some money. And finally, we have Tito Mahi. He works alongside Mario in the assembly department as a quality control tech. He's the voice of reason in the assembly department and frequently puts things in perspective with his always motivating tone and empathy. However, he can sometimes be messy and doesn't worry too much about using excessive resources. Episode 4 is immediately following the team meeting in Episode 3, which Derek called in order to address problems that he theorizes are leading to a lower profit margin. You'll recall how in Episode 3, Derek covered steps 3 through 5 in the decision-making process, rationality model. This naturally set the stage for Episode 4 to highlight step 6, which is, of course, implementing the decision. Now, this episode is where the rubber really hits the road. Derek's got his problems and opportunities identified, he's got his solutions picked out, and now he's going to act. The first problem he decides to tackle is the inventory shrinkage that's going on in the assembly department, and it's interesting that he went for this decision with little to no pause, as if it were a programmed decision, and he very quickly drafts the worksheet which the assembly department is going to use to record their supplies on. Then he moves over to the next problem, which is a training deficiency in a sales associate. And to tackle this, he uses Tina, his creative designer. He leverages her specialized job skills and schedules a day for the sales associate to shadow her. That way she can learn about the product directly from its creator. He also uses Tina's knowledge to assist him in the next problem, which is a billing error. Derek calls an outside source to get a beat on the competition and briefly perform a SWOT analysis where Tina provides the strengths that give their product a competitive advantage. Now, the whole time this meeting is going on, the other employees at NACCTS are crowded outside of the office, pondering what's going on behind that closed door. Mario's trying to stir up a little bit of groupthink by keeping the idea of big changes in the forefront of everybody's mind. But the other members diffuse it with a positive attitude. Now in Episode 5, Derek poses his findings, solutions, and proposals before the board members of NACCTS Engineering. It starts off with Derek in his car, presumably in the parking lot of NACCTS headquarters. He's building up his self-efficacy by reestablishing to himself that he can handle the daunting task of standing before his board and delivering these proposals. This board, just a week prior, practically threatened his job, so he provides himself with a little extra boost of confidence by stating that he is the very definition of motivation. Now, upon entering the meeting room, he nervously greets everybody, and right from the start, there's an obvious sense of ethnocentrism. Derek is clearly in the outgroup of this board meeting. The CEO continually intimidates him and installs negative reinforcement several times throughout the duration of the meeting. In one incident, Derek is posing a problem before the board, which the chief financial officer takes personally and challenges Derek's process redesign before it is even presented. Despite everything, Derek sticks to his management concepts, stands his ground, and demonstrates accountability, a key aspect in the development of an action plan. After taking this course, we've come to find that management is similar to red car syndrome. If you're unfamiliar with the term, it goes a little something like this. You don't notice how many red cars are on the road until you purchase one yourself, and then you notice them everywhere. The same application is right here. After learning principles of management covered in the course, it's amazing how you can find their application in the most unexpected of scenarios. Also, no matter how much you think you know about a specific management principle, you'll soon find that there's much more for you to learn. Reflecting on this course, I feel that I've learned the principles of management on two levels. Being a junior, I've been accustomed to learning the traditional way, by means of reading a text. Now in this course, tradition stops right there. While we do read the text weekly, Dr. D'Ascio throws tradition out the window by offering an alternative way to actually apply what we're learning in a practical sense. Now, you read it, you understand it, and then you submit your understanding of it by acting it out in the puppet show. And on top of that, you're also actively exercising management concepts as you manage and work within your groups as you complete milestones, design challenges, and other assignments. My recommendations for this course are as follows. First, you need to understand that this course is largely a group effort. As such, Your first priority, literally, the day that you assign your groups, should be to establish what communication methods you'll be utilizing throughout the duration of this course. Without communication, you have nothing but stress. Secondly, get to know your group members' work ethic as well as their routine schedules. Week to week, you want to be consistent about when and how you work together. Also, early on, you want to do a skill inventory on your group members, notably, a pre-existing experience in theater or computer animation or anything of that sort will be a skill that you definitely want to utilize early on in this course. Lastly, I encourage everybody to work ahead. This course is wide open from day one. Take advantage of it.
Hi, this is Ashley Luzon, and this is my reflections for the course and my recommendations. I would say this course was well organized to accommodate the group environment and allow for the students to work well together while still maintaining the online learning. The writing logs were a tool to work independently, while the design challenges and milestone assignments called for group work and group input. I enjoyed working in a group and the collaboration and combining all our skills and how that can produce a much more in-depth final product than working independently. Group projects allow for you to gain the experience that you will need in working in your career, and I think they are an excellent opportunity to learn the skills in collaboration. As far as recommendation, I did think that the professor was involved too much to agree by students in the group. I would think it would have been a better choice to email the other students if another student had a concern instead of going straight to the professor, just in my opinion, in the work environment if there's a problem. You talk to your colleagues first regarding your concerns and not go straight to the boss. That's just my recommendation for future students. And as far as reflection, I also recommend to students in the future to stay on top of deadlines and you'll do stellar work as a group. I'd say it was overall a very enjoyable experience and that I liked working with everyone. It was a great group of people and everyone did excellent work. I just want to say Patrick's animation was amazing and it was nice working with him. And that is my reflection. Thank you.
Fatima Gilmanova, reflection. As a person who avoided teamwork throughout her college years, fell right into the center of one in this class. I cannot say that I dislike it because I very much did enjoy every single moment of it. The team members were productive, eager, and attentive. Even though we waited until Sunday to turn in all of our work, we did a great job overall. The results were fantastic. It was a pleasure working in groups. Additionally, the management class helped me learn a great deal about what managers are and what they go through in the business world. The business world should not be taken into granted because one thing gone wrong can cause a downfall in one's business. I learned that to be successful, a person must be productive and be dedicated to his or her job. Recommendations. I would strongly recommend students who take this class online to be very productive. An online environment requires constant attention and time. However, I cannot say that it is difficult. The management class went very well in an online environment with the participation of most of the team members. Participation is the most important factor in this class because majority of the work is done in groups. If one person fails to participate, then the rest of the team members have trouble finishing the assignments. Communicate. As we have learned, communication and negotiation is an essential part of business. Since all of the work was done online for this class, face-to-face communication was impossible. Therefore, we figured out other ways to communicate. The important thing is to compromise in a mode of communication. Deadlines. Be aware of the deadlines because one missed assignment could affect your grade negatively. Be sure to mark your calendars on when assignments are due. Be positive. Remember that if anything goes wrong, there will be a time to fix it. Don't give up.
No assumptions should be made regarding a course's content prior to both physically and or mentally engaging within the course's content. As such, the limitations of an online course become increasingly negligible as time passes. In terms of group involvement and communication, theorizing and examining methods of collaboration will undoubtedly demand for a greater portion of time than the assignments themselves. Discovering the solutions to these issues will improve the execution of each task portion.
Hi, this is Alex Walter. This is my reflection. First off, the class was not 100% user-friendly for online takers. Very difficult for communications without the face-to-face roundtable-like feel. The conference on Canvas was great. It helped fill in the gaps quite nicely. It just wasn't the same. Aside from that, the project was fun. I enjoyed the group I was with, and our group leader was absolutely stellar. He really made the project what it was, and I gotta give all my thanks to Patrick. He made the project just great. Outside of that, I would say the writing logs and the lessons that went with them were really fun. I didn't really realize how much of it I used on a day-to-day, and it allowed me to make my day-to-day better. So that was nice. Design challenges were also surprisingly fun. Overall, I would say this class grew on me over the semester, and to round it all out, I would say it was an enjoyable class, and I'm really glad I took it.